Hi, if you've ever wondered how to wire up one of those solenoid valves to an irrigation controller, well, this is exactly what we'll be showing you today. Hi, and welcome to 3-Minute Thursdays. I'm Matt, and we're starting a brand new video series to show you clever gardening ideas, DIY tips and skills, and how you get started in your garden. To start off, we'll be showing you how to wire up a solenoid valve to an irrigation controller. A solenoid valve is essentially an automatic tap. Using a magnet within the solenoid coil, the valve can be turned on or off remotely by an irrigation controller. In this video, we will be demonstrating how to wire a K-Range solenoid valve into the new WX8 Wi-Fi Irrigation Controller, including a master valve. A master valve works like a backup valve. When the irrigation controller signals the solenoid valve to open, it also opens the master valve at the same time. When no valves are operating, the master valve will shut off all watering to your irrigation system. By shutting off the master valve, the system's pipework is not under pressure. At Tolman, we arrange manifolds just like these. They come in 2, 3, and 4-way configurations. This very simple product eliminates extra products such as tees or elbows. You would screw in the master valve at the end, just like that. And then attach the solenoid valves that are there to activate your stations in the individual sides here. Making sure you have the master valve the right way around, the K-Range master valve has little arrows which indicate which way the water should run through the solenoid. Now take your solenoid valve and connect it to the rest of the manifold. Use a little nipple to connect it to the solenoid. Use tape to reduce any leakage around it. And let's screw it in. Just hand tighten it, will do, don't over tighten, and make sure again that you look at the arrows to follow the water flow direction. Once connected to the manifold, separate the cables on your solenoid, and you will see that there's two cables coming out of the solenoid. Pick one to be your common cable, and pick the other one to be your active cable. Open your WX8 irrigation controller box. Take the bottom panel out and you will see where the cables will have to go. Take the active wire from the master valve. Unscrew the little screw on the terminal that's marked M. Feed in the active cable in and hand tighten the screw. Other brands of controllers might call that P or S on the terminal block. Now take your common wire from the master valve and the common cable from your solenoid valve and put them together. Undo the screw on the irrigation controller that's marked C. Put in the wire and hand tighten the screw. Now there should be one cable left on your solenoid valve. That's your active cable. This will determine whichever station you would like to designate to your solenoid valve. Now, if you want your solenoid to activate station 1, you would connect the active cable to station 1 on your controller. It is marked 1 on your terminal block. If you want that solenoid to be station 2, you would connect it to station 2 on the controller. 3, 4, and so on. To test that everything is wired up correctly, make sure that your controller is plugged into PowerPoint and runs power. You can actually see that by the illuminated LEDs on the controller box. You then want to turn the dial to station 1 and press start, and your solenoid should be making a humming sound. There you have it, guys. You successfully wired up your controller to your solenoid valves. In the next video, we'll be talking about the WX8 Wi-Fi controller, how to set it up with a phone and all the cool functions that come with it, Thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you smart gardeners in the next video.